I think it was a good course. It's appropriate. It was quite professional. I see the very, very high level of teamwork and interdisciplinary job here, and I appreciate to get the chance to participate in such a course. The schedule and the program and how they did it, I think it was quite good. I'm quite satisfied with this. Everything was in place. We had little bit changes, but it was not a big problem. It was enough place for everyone, and we appreciate the fact that there was not so many participants. It was quite professional, 4 or 5 participants, and the rest of the team, which was, I guess, was 7 or 8 person. We had the access to see everything and to discuss it live during the surgery. I appreciate it. It was very interactive discussion between the participants and the surgeons, prosthodontists also, and anesthesiologist. Everything, I think, worked very well. Of course, these models do not represent exact the situation that we have in the mouth and in the skull, but it's a good practice. We cannot expect 100% same situation in the mouth, but it's a practice. As other practice, you have to accept a little bit differences. And as dentist surgeons, we had done this before. We have some experience. We know the differences, and I think we can do it well. Surgeons, I think they are very good. They do a very good job. Maxillofacial surgeon, I appreciate his work. He's very, very professional, high level of quality of the treatment. And implantologists, we had 2 implantologists, and it was great for us to have both of them at the same time. And they checked each other at the same time. And we will see the 4 eyes always check the implant directions, anesthesiologists at place. Everything was great. Even the assistant of the surgery was a dentist, good knowledge and competency in surgeries. I think it was very good. Prosthetic model, theoretical part, it was great. But you know, I'm not a prosthodontist. I have less knowledge about this. I'm not the right person to judge this part, but according to me, not prosthodontist, I evaluate it and I judge it as a high level of competency. If I want to be 100% honest, I have told to the boss and the leader of this team, Dr. Kamal, I have a suggestion. If they can accept it, I think a periodontist in a team is a must. According to me, of course, I'm a periodontist. I hope I'm not biased by this, but this is that I truly believe in. I have some colleagues. They are maxillofacial surgeons. They are very good. But they don't do zygomatic implant surgery. Some of them are interested. I can recommend this course for them. But for periodontists, if you are a periodontist with a very, very high level of education, competency, and experience, and you did advanced implant surgeries, yeah. It can be an alternative, but still I think a maxillofacial surgeon should be beside a periodontist when we do such a surgery, especially quad zygoma. This is my opinion. I have got this opportunity to talk to implantologist and also maxillofacial surgeon about my treatment. I have another approach. They have another approach, and probably the same good results, and it's very, very good to share experiences and the knowledge that we have. Even it's different, but it can help us to go further with a little bit wider spectrum of the knowledge about the implantology. I do appreciate it, actually. I think on one hand, it's better to start doing this as soon as possible, since it's fresh in your brain. But at the same time, logistic is not so easy. I have to find good maxillofacial surgeon, of course I have one, anesthesiologist and the team, prosthodontist. That part probably takes months, not weeks. Great man. I cannot say that I just participated in a course with a high level of proficiency that he showed us. I found a good friend. And I appreciate it. It comes from my heart. I don't have anything else in my heart about this man. He's a good man. He does his job very good. This is what I see, and I say it directly.